contents, introduction, history, acquisition, STP analysis, financials, customer base, competitors, and reasons for success of BMW.
No murmuring, please.
So, it's a dream car of every people, as we know. BMW stands for Bavarian Motor Works. It was born in the year of 1916, and it was previously named as Rapp Motors. It is an automobile industry, and the founder was Karl Rapp and Gustav Otto. Chairman of BMW India is Vikram Pawar. Headquarter, Bavaria, Germany, and in India, it's Chennai. There are a number of employees. There are 1,29,932 employees over the world, and in India, it's near about 200 plus. Okay, and it's launched in India in 2006, and the number of dealers in India is 37, and itself in Mumbai is 6.
Now let's talk about history of BMW. The journey of BMW started on the year 1916. They started their business with the production of aircraft engines, and because of the First World War, they stopped production because of the Treaty of Versailles, which was between the Germany and allied countries, and so that they switched in the production of the motorbikes on 1923, and after that in 1930 they also started the manufacturing automobile aircraft engines. Then in 1928 they started manufacturing automobiles. In 1959, because of their consecutive three models are flop, so that's why their debt is increasing and they are losing money, so they are near to the bankruptcy. But because of launching the model 1600 model, which was today also, it was replaced by the 2 series and 3 series model. Which become the important model, so that they cope up with the bankruptcy stage. Acquisition. BMW acquired two topmost company, Rolls-Royce and Mini Cooper. Rolls-Royce was earlier under the parent company Vickers, and Volkswagen and BMW both want to hire Rolls-Royce, but Vickers, the parent company of Rolls-Royce, sell the half of the rights to the Volkswagen and half of the rights to the BMW. Because of that, the Rolls-Royce company is the treated like the, which is very complicated. Their rights are 50-50 divided to Volkswagen and BMW. But after two, three years, the BMW acquired the complete Rolls-Royce rights. And in 2004, it also acquired Mini Cooper.
STP analysis. STP stands for segmentation, targeting, and positioning. Segments. Geographically, they basically focus on the industrialized areas like North America, Europe, and in India, like cities Mumbai, Pune, Bangalore, Chennai, and etc. Targeting, they basically targets people between the age of 35 to 50, and their income is more than 20 lakhs. Positioning. Performance, quality, and technology. They never compromise with their technologies. They always try to innovate their new technologies, like BMW. BMW was the first one who offers my remote mobile. With the help of that, people can open the ACs and they can honk the horns and etc.
Now let's talk about market share and market size. Market share of all the luxury cars in India is 20,170 crore approximately. And Mercedes acquired 38% of the market, BMW 27%, Audi 16%, JLR, which is Jaguar and Land Rover, is 12%, Volvo 7%.
Sales. sales and units. Mercedes sold cars in 2017 was 15,330, and in 18 it was 15,538. This was a growth rate of 1.36%. And BMW sold in 2017 it was 9,800 cars, and in 2018 it was 11,105. The total growth rate was 13.32%. Audi was facing some issues, like they sold their car in 2017 7,876, but in 2018 they sold only 6,463. According to the head of Audi's, they said that in Delhi NCR the supplier of the distributor of Delhi NCR was closed at that in 2018. That's why they faces that issues. JLR and the growth rate was decreased to 17.94%. JLR in 2017 they sold cars 3,954, and in 18 they sold 4,596. The total growth rate was 16.24%. Volvo they sold 2,029 in 2017, and in 18 2,638. The total growth rate was 30%. The total sold the BMW sold 11,105 cars, and the 50% of the cars were SUVs. The total units sold in India in 2017 was 38,989, and in 18 40,340.
Now let's talk about the consumer base of BMW all over the world. It is in Britain 11%, USA 21%, Europe 24%, Germany 21%, and in India 14%, 7% in China. The world 13,41,048 cars are acquired by the customers of the world.
So here are the competitors: Mercedes, Audi, Volvo, and Volkswagen. Mercedes, we just mentioned that charts which car is competing with which car, which other car of the other companies. BMW 1 Series competing with Audi A3 and Mercedes A-Class. And BMW 2nd Series is competing with A3 and Mercedes with B-Class. And Volvo, BMW is competing with 3 Series with A4 with Audi, and in Mercedes C-Class. These are the sedans, segments of sedans, and the SUV sector are X3 and X4. They are competing with Audi with Q5 and Q7, and with Mercedes Benz GLC. Both are Benz GLC actually. Here the sales of all models of BMWs, the most successful the most percentage change in the cars was X1. In 2018 they sold 2,086,743, but in 2017 they sold only 2,20,317. It's a worldwide data actually, and the change in percentage was 30%, and the worst performing was X4. They sold 52,167 in 2018, but they sold 58,051 in 2017. There was a decline in their growth rate.
Now the reasons for the success of BMW. First, BMW spends 25% of their profits into R&D. No other company spends 25% of their profit in R&D. That's why it is the unique quality of BMW. They believe in product variation. Their models are never similar in their features. Their features are always different from their previous models. Product quality and customer relations is the most important feature they focus on. Always focuses on technology upgradation. Latest technology upgradation is that my BMW remote app, which is easy to control the car with the smartphone. Remote control parking, which helps in parking BMW in a correct situation. These are the references from where we store our focus.